This is historic Pleasant Green Missionary Baptist Church, 540 West Maxwell Street, Lexington, Kentucky. My name is Reverend Wendell S. Emerson. I'm just one of the associate ministers here this morning. It's my pleasure to be able to greet you in our name and Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I want you all to remember that God loves you and the church loves you. And we want to let you know that God has not forsake you. And don't you never forget that. He's always with you. In light of that, I want to say, God is the Spirit. They that worship Him, worship in spirit and in truth. We're excited this morning to be able to share the minister of music with us, Brother Marion Shockey. He's here today, and we're going to ask him to render the music for this morning.
Speak to my heart, Lord. Oh, oh, oh. speak to my heart, Lord. Oh, speak to my heart, Lord. Speak to my heart, Lord.
The Lord with me, bless the Lord with me. Come on and bless the Lord with me, bless the Lord with me. Everybody, bless the Lord with me, bless the Lord with me. Come on and bless the Lord with me.
Let me go in and our morning scripture can be found in the Gospel according to John, the Gospel according to John, the first chapter, all 11 verses. Gospel according to John, the first chapter, all 11 verses. It says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God, and all things made by him, without him was not anything that was made. In him was life, and life was the light of men, and light shining in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended not. There was a man sent from God, whose name was John. The same came for the witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but he was sent to bear witness of that light. That the light, that the true light, which light of every man that cometh into the Father, he was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came into his own, and his own received him not. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading, holy, and righteous word of God this morning. Let's pray. Father, help me come this time. We come, thank you for the wonderful day, a day that was not promised to us, but we allow to wake up today to say thank you, Jesus. We pray, oh God, the richest blessings upon the church as a whole. We pray that you bless all those who decide to come and join us in this virtual worship service. We pray for all our spiritual leaders of the church, Brother Speed, and all the officers and missionaries. We pray that you can bless them as they try to continue on in doing God's business. Lord, we need you. We need you. We need you today. Tomorrow is not promised us. We know, I already know who holds tomorrow, but we need you today. So we ask the Spirit of living God to fall fresh on me so I'd be able to share. It's your word. It's not mine. It's your word. just gave me the strength to deliver in such a way to help somebody to say, what must I do to be saved? To help somebody hold on, that there is hope. The hope is in Jesus Christ. Help somebody to have the patience. We need you, Lord. We call upon you because you know you do all things well and you have all power. In the name of Jesus we pray, amen. All right, my brothers and sisters, I want to thank you again for the opportunity to be able to share with you. But I want you to please turn with me, turn me to two passages of scriptures. One is in Joel, some people call it Joel, J-O-E-L, second chapter, 32a. Then after you get that, turn to Acts 2:21. It reads the following. It said, and it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered. In Acts 2:21, King James Version for both of these, it said, and it shall come to pass that whosoever call on the name of the Lord shall be saved. My title today is something that the phrase you probably have already heard many times, and I know definitely in the past 2-3 weeks. It says, say his name. Say his name. Now, you're probably thinking that you there's nothing common uncommon about that name. The fact that, like I said, you've heard it many times throughout the week and throughout the past few years about saying somebody's name. but the strangest thing is how this title came to me. That's what I'm going to focus on, how this title came to me. Say his name. Say her name is something that was given out in February 2015. It was a social movement that seeks to raise awareness of black female victims of the police brutality and the anti-black violence in the United States. Black Lives Matter joined in with the Associated Press, contributed to this report in June 7, 2020. It says, the title of this particular one, it says, Say Their Names, Stories of Black American Killed by the Police. It was written by a man named Alex Meyer. The message from protesters, he said, around the United States is that George Floyd is the latest addition to a grim roster of African-Americans to be killed by police. In demonstration after demonstration, protesters are carrying signs that include the names of other blacks who lives ended cruelly in encounters with the police. Here's some few of the names. It's Ahmaud Arbery, Mike Brown, Terrence Crutcher, Eric Garner, Oscar Grant, Freddie Gray, Betty Jones, Trayvon Martin, Daquan McDonald, Tamir Rice, Breonna Taylor, and Dominique White. Now we can now add another name, would be Jacob Blake, who experienced cruelty from the police recently. The protesters were carrying signs and calling out their names and telling the world not to forget the injustice and the cruelties coming from people who was hired to protect them. Let me tell you a true story starting on July 14, 2020. I was in a parade. This parade was sponsored by Whistleworks, a nonprofit organization. It was designed to allow senior citizens and young people, young adults, all kind of ages, to take part in a drive-by parade. This parade would allow that the children be able to communicate with the adults and ask the question, what's going on? This parade actually allowed people that were senior citizens had issues, underlying health issues, that they could not march with the rest of them, but they had a desire to be out there to march. Well, I was able to do that. I remember pulling up in Douglas Park, and I pulled beside a white elderly lady who had both hands on the wheels, and you couldn't even see her head. But she was ready to go with the rest of the about 50 to 60 vehicles leaving from Douglas Park. She had her own sign. Her own sign said, Black Lives Matter. I said, and so we took off and we went on down to the holding stage, the next holding stage down around Charles Young Center. For some strange reason, I got made a wrong turn. And when I made a wrong turn, I found myself had to turn around and so I could get back in line with the rest of the cars because there were more vehicles waiting for us when we got down to Charles Young Center. So when we got there to Charles Young Center, there was an elderly white man was in the front car. He had his sign, and he had his sign, he was ready to go. And he had it on a cardboard, and the cardboard said, Black Lives Matter. Well, we took off going on downtown, blowing, everybody blowing. I was excited. I was excited that I was able to be a part of something, that I was able to be part of the protest, because I was in pain too, like everybody else should be in pain, of all the injustice that's been going on around our country. But I was excited, I was very excited. And then I was blowing my horn, And all of a sudden, somebody else was blowing their horn. I looked at the man that had the cardboard, he had it hanging outside, holding up down, said, Black Lives Matter. I said, Lord have mercy. Well, we finished at that time, and I got home. My wife asked me, and she said, where you been? I said, I've been in the parade. But I was all excited. I had all this energy inside of me, knowing that I was actually able to take part in a protest just like that. But here's the thing. Two days later, I was riding my van, trying to make sure I took care of some people. I have a little job. I would take some flowers to some people around this city. But 2 days later, a still small voice came into my van. Mercer. And the voice said, I saw you. You had a good time, didn't you? I saw you. I saw the sign that you had on your van. On your van, you had, remember, George Floyd and Breonna Taylor. So I saw you. You had a good time. He said, I'm proud of you. I'm glad that you was able to get that energy out of you. I'm proud of you. He said, but the next time you step into that pulpit, you tell the church to say my name. I said, oh, Lord. You hear me? Tell the pulpit to say my name. Say my name, he said, the still small voice. Say my name. And this is the reason why I want you to say my name. The first reason I want you to say my name, because the earth is the Lord, and the fullness thereof, and there, and the world, and they that dwell in. The earth is the Lord, and the fullness thereof, the world, and they that dwell. Let's look at this for a few minutes. The earth is the Lord. Let's stop right there. The whole world belongs to God, and he is the creator of the earth, and therefore, he's the owner of it. And in other words, it belongs to God. God, in his highest possible sense, has a right to the earth and to all which it produces, and being all of the creation of his hand and the fruit of his culture and his skill, he has a right to dispose of it as he pleases. By fire, by flood, by tempest, he has an equal right to direct man in what way he shall employ them portions of the production of the earth which may be entrusted to him. All the right which any person has in any portion of the earth's surface are to what is treasured up in this earth, or to what it may be produced is subordinate to the claims of God, and all should be yielded up at the binding, whether he comes and claims it to be employed in his service, or whether he comes and sweeps it away by fire, flood, or locusts. Well, my brothers and sisters, say his name, I'm telling you, because he is the creator. The other part of the scripture says, and the fullness thereof, in which it contains everything goes to fill the world, the animals, the minerals, the vegetables, the people, all belong to God, and he has a right to claim them for his service and dispose of them as he pleases. Even the world, I'm talking about, my brothers, say his name. He says, tell them to say my name. And then his scripture said, and they that dwell therein, and all the inhabitants of the earth, embraces men and animals and all kinds. God has a claim on people,
upon his service, upon his talents, upon all that he can acquire by labor and skill. He has the right to all that fly in the air, all that walk on earth, all that swim in the sea. The earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof, and the world that dwell therein. Say his name because he is our helper. God is our refuge and strength and a very present help in trouble. God is our refuge and strength. God is for us a place to which we may flee for safety, a source of strength for us in danger. The first word is refuge, which a verb means to flee. And then to flee, or you could talk about to flee to, or to take shelter in. The notes a place which one will flee in time of danger, as a lofty wall, as a high tower, a fort or a fortress. The word strength here implies that God is a source of strength for those who are weak and are defenseless, or that he may rely on his strength as if it was our own, or that he may feel as safe in a strength as though he had the strength of ourselves. Say his name, I tell you, my brothers and sisters, say his name. He's a very present help. A very present help in trouble. The word help talked about here means aid and assistance. The word trouble will cover all that can come upon us, which would give us anxiety and sorrow. The word present has been found. That is, he has proved himself to be the help in times of trouble. The word present, as if he was near to us, close by us. He has always proved himself to be such an help, that therefore he may now confide in him. Lord, I tell you, say his name, because he is our helper. Let me make it plain to you what I'm about ready to say this. Alice, my wife, was tested for the COVID virus. And she would test for COVID, she tested positive, but I just tested negative. So what we had to do in our house, we had to isolate ourselves. I had to take one room and she had to take the other room. But one night she came knocking on my door. And she said, Daddy, I sit down. She said, Wendell, she said, look, she said, I cannot smell. And I looked at her and she went back into the room. And I went ahead and went follow her in the room with Kelly and I. So we got the spelling test and make sure to see what was going on. And I could see the stress was on her face. I could see how she was, how stressed she was at the time. And so we did the test to see what that said. And she couldn't smell certain things that we was giving to her. And I said, well, Alice, let's pray. So we prayed. And after praying, I said, it's going to be all right. But what happened? I went back to my room. But when I went back to my room, and I said to the Lord, I called out his name. I said, Lord, have mercy on her. Let me take the pain from her. Don't let her experience this pain that could lead into a whole lot of trouble for her. Let me take this pain. Well, I went to sleep. I know she went to sleep. I went to sleep, but somehow during that nighttime, I woke up. The reason why I woke up, because I was shaking. I shook for 15 minutes in the bed all by myself. I didn't know what was going on, but I shook for 15 minutes all by myself. I'm trying to make this point so you understand he's a helper. Well, after that, I went back to sleep after 15 minutes. And then I woke up the next morning to do my regular routine to go check on my wife and see how she was doing. I walked in there and I looked at her and I said, how you doing? And she said, I feel pretty good. I still can't smell, she said. I said, oh Lord, I know what happened. Well, I tell you, the Lord is, I tell you, God is our refuge and our strength and a very present help in time of trouble. He's a right there God. He took care of what I asked him because I called out on his name. His name is Jesus. I said, Lord, help her. Let me take the pain. Don't let her experience what she about ready to experience. Let me take the pain. I took that pain, and the only thing I can say, have thank you, Jesus, for what you have done for me. Say his name, I tell you, my brother and sister. Say his name. His name. Say his name because he's our Savior. In Romans 10 and 13, it said, whosoever call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Look at here. Whosoever call the name of the Lord, this is a testimony. Testimony was taken out of Job 2 and 32. It shall become to pass that whosoever call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered. Call upon the name of the Lord, Jesus Christ. Call upon him and find him rich and overflowing in mercy and ready to dispense his grace, his salvation to them. Such shall be saved. To call on the name of the Lord is the same as to call on the Lord himself. To call on him is to acknowledge him and that he is our sovereign, he is our father, and he is our friend. Say his name. Don't be afraid to say his name. Say his name because he is our Savior. Say his name because he knows about getting in good trouble. Oh, yeah. He knows about getting in good trouble. A lot of people think that John Roberts was coined that phrase. Reverend John Roberts Lewis. Yeah, you heard of it. That's all you've been hearing about that. But who called John Roberts? It was the Lord. Who told John Roberts to go out there and preach to the chickens? It was the Lord. Who was with him for 45 times he was placed in jail? It was the Lord. Who was with him when he crossed the Edmund Pettus Bridge and they cracked him upside his head? It was the Lord. I tell you, say his name because he know a whole lot about getting in good trouble. Isaiah, you got to go read Isaiah 53, 2 and 8 when you take your time. He said he grew up talking about Jesus. He grew up like a young plant, rooted, sprouting in the dry land. The servant grew up obeying the Lord. He wasn't a handsome king like a lot of people have him to be. Nothing about the way he looked made him attractive. This points up here, talked about this verse here, the second verse, points up the prophet described the humble appearance of the Messiah. He was hated. He was rejected. His life was filled with sorrow, terrible suffering. No one wanted to look at him. We despise him and said he's a nobody. He suffered and endured great pain for us. But we thought his suffering was a punishment from God. No, it was for us. The scripture said, but he was wounded for our transgression. Let's talk about good trouble. He was bruised for our iniquity. Let's talk about good trouble. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. Let's talk about good trouble. And his stripes we was healed. Let's talk about good trouble. Well, why was he wounded? He was wounded because of sin. Sin is talking about missing the mark. Sin is a general term for everything that falls short in the glory of God. Look at Romans 3:23. Transgression, he talked about in scripture. Transgression refers to the presumptuous sin. The transgress is to choose the intentional disobeying. Transgression is willingly, it's a willful trespassing. Samson intentionally broke his Nazarite vow by touching the dead lion. He intentionally allowed his hair to be cut off. In doing so, he was committed transgression. Iniquity is talked about. Iniquity refers to the premeditated choice. To commit iniquity is to continue without repentance. David sinned with Bathsheba and led him to killing her husband, Uriah. Was iniquity. Chastising of peace, the act of chastening, pain inflicted a punishment and correction and discipline and punishment. We got peace because of his chastisement for our peace. His stripes was healed. With his stripes we are healed. These stripes were administered by a whip, whipped on our back, on his back, as a prisoner, those with his hands. Hands and feet was bound, rendered him helpless. The phrase here, the stripes, we are healed, refers to the punishment of Jesus Christ. Say his name. His suffering with the whip and the beating and his fist was followed by the agonizing death on that cross. He took upon himself all the sins of all people who believe Jesus Christ is Lord and Savior. Say his name. But he was wounded. He was wounded. He was wounded for our transgression. He was wounded, I tell you. He wounded spoken here is that it would result in a severe injury. The Hebrew word literally means pierced. Pierced. It was our sin that did that. They ripped him. They tore him. They crushed him. As for our sin, the pierce of Jesus Christ in his hands. Can't you see the nails in his hands? Can't you see the nails in his feet? That was for us. Can't you see how they pierced me inside? That was for us. Head, they put a crown of thorns on his head. That was for us. The shedding of his blood was for us. He was condemned to death without a fair trial. Can't you see what's going on across America right now? He was there. He knows a whole lot about getting a fair trial. Who could have imagined what would have happened to him? His life was taken away because of the sinful things of our people would be done. He wasn't a dishonest man. He wasn't a violent man. He was buried in a barred tomb. A tomb, I tell you, on a Friday. They buried him in a barred tomb. But thank God, he got up early on a Sunday morning. Thank God he got up. Same thing, because he knows a whole lot about getting in good trouble. Call on his name, Jesus, who is a healer. Call on his name, Jesus, who is a provider. Call on his name, Jesus, who is our protector. Call on his name, Jesus, who is our deliverer. Hey, say his name, but guess what? You can say his name because he shall return. Oh, yeah, he's coming back. He got up with all power in heaven and earth, but he's coming back. How do I know? Because the word said, for the Lord himself shall he just shall descend from heaven with a shout. Shout. Are you ready to hear the shout? Shout with the voice of the archangels and with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then which we are alive and remain shall be caught up together with him, with them in the cloud, to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Say his name. What's his name? Jesus. Say his name. Are you lonely? Say his name. Are you need some help? Say his name. Do you need food? Say his name. Do you feel like you're not protected? Call on the name. Call on the name. In the name of Jesus, say his name. Name, Jesus, 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 say his name. Well, I don't know about you. I know what he can do. If he can take care of me and take care of others, he can take care of you. Say his name. My brothers and sisters, that's what we talk about for those who may not know the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. You have an opportunity to call out the name of Jesus, and he'll be right there ready to take care of you. If you want more information about Jesus, you can call here at Pleasant Green Baptist Church. It's 258-594-7387. Call on him. Call us. And I would be glad to talk to you more about the one that I say his name. Because he's a savior. He saved me, and he can save you. May God bless you this morning. Say his name. His name is Jesus. Don't you forget that. God bless you.
Place, Lord, you are.
are welcome in this place. Lord, you are welcome in this place. Have your way. Lord, you are welcome in this place. Lord, you are welcome in this place. Lord, you are welcome in this place. Have your way. Heal and deliver in this place. Heal and deliver in this place. Heal and deliver in this place.
Thank you, Brother Shockley. Thank you for the invitation song. We appreciate you here at Pleasant Bay Missionary Baptist Church. Thank you. It's a pleasure to be able to stand before you in the name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I thank God for each and every one of you. I thank God for all the prayers. We need to continue to pray for the church. We need to continue to pray for the pulpit committee. We need to continue to pray for all the sick that have been in our church. We have some recent death members. Our church members, we need to pray for the Dunn's family as well and the Hatches family as well. We need to pray for them, Lord, and church family. Pray, I'm telling you. But while you're praying, make sure you say the name. You say the name. I love you. This church loves you, but God loves you more. Now, receive the benediction. Now, may the grace of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ rest, rule, and abide henceforth and forevermore. Say amen in your church. Say his name. Amen.